Hello, this is Claude, and today's video is a public service video, actually, for those who have a Vonage box, the box number or the model number VDV22-VC. I've had my box for more than 10 years, and it kind of stopped recognizing the phone line, and the customer service at Vonage, both Canada and the USA, is so horrible that you call them, ask them for a new box, and they won't ship me a new box. Basically, I had to take the matters into my own hands and fix it myself, and today I'm going to show you how to do that. The issue is when the everything connects to the internet, except that you do not see that little telephone LED on the Vonage box telling you that the phone is connected, and you receive the message, this telephone line cannot register to the Vonage network.
This telephone line cannot register to the Vonage network.
So in order to fix that, what we're going to do is very easy. We're going to open the box, and we're going to probably, that's what I did, replace four capacitors, all right? So to open the box, what you need to do, turn it around. The first thing you need to do is to remove the little rubber pads at each corner. Before doing that, I use a heat gun. I heat it a little bit. Don't overdo it. You don't want to melt the plastic. And then I use my little iFixit pry tool. Once it's warm, to remove the little pads. Once the four pads are removed, we're going to remove the screws. And the screws are Torx screws. And I've used a number 8-bit. And I... once I reinstall them at the end, I used the Torx 9 and it worked as well. So I think it's Torx 9, actually. I lost my 8-bit in the process. This is the size of the screws. You remove all four screws. After that, sometimes in electronics, there's always a screw under the decal with the serial number and the model. On this box, there is no such a thing, so no need to remove the decal. I did remove it because I could feel some kind of indentation, but there's nothing there. All right, so no need to remove that. After the four screws are removed, you are going to separate the body from itself, and it's from the PCB. And the PCB is just resting in there, so just be careful when you open the body for the PCB to not just fall off. All right, once the PCB is the body is separated, remove the PCB, and you will remove as well the IO shield, the plastic shield, and it's just affixed there with double-sided tape on the power plug, so you can just heat it up a little bit and just gently pry it off, and it's easy to do. All right, after that, what you're going to do, what I did as well myself, is I verified for any sign of physical damage, any short circuit, or if anything was blown, or if I could see signs of a physical stress on the board. I've seen none of that. I put my magnifying lenses, and I couldn't see nothing. So what I've done is I replaced the four capacitors that are on the board. So you have four of them, and the one, if you look at the board with the IO shield, the connectors in the top, the top right capacitor is a 220 microfarads, 16 volts. The one just behind it, in the middle to the right of the board, you have a 1000 microfarads, 6.3 volts. And the bottom left, the two larger capacitor bottom left, are 33 microfarads, 200 volts. And I was able to match the first two capacitors and buy them in the local electronics store for less than a dollar each, obviously cents for each. But the 33 microfarad, the 200 volts, I couldn't find exact match, but I could find 33 microfarads at 250 volts. And this is what I did install. Don't go under, but you can go over. All right. To remove them, obviously you're going to desolder the four caps. For me, I just use my Hakko soldering iron to desolder these. And I've tried to use the little sucker, the plastic sucker thing that you buy for $10. It didn't work. Actually, it took me, it's a 5-minute job. Desoldering this thing. It took me 2 hours. I just couldn't do it. Actually, I purchased the Hacko desoldering gun for about, I don't know, $380 Canadian. I will never have to fight to desolder as a component. That's ridiculous. Even with the wick, the desoldering wick, I just couldn't get it to clear the holes. So that could be a little challenge, but if you have this desoldering wick, and a lot of patience, you will get it done. After this, the four capacitors are out. I cleaned with isopropyl 99%. And after that, I just reinstalled the new caps and resoldered everything. I use no clean flux and no clean solder. So it's easier. I still clean after that with the isopropyl once it's ever said and done, but it's an overkill. That's why I use the no clean, but I still clean it. All right. Once everything is done, you reinstall the PCB into the body. You pre-install the IO shield before reinserting that. And also you just use the same sticky tape to the power plug, and it's going to stay there in place just nice. And after that, you just reconnect the whole Vonage box to the power, to the network cable, and as well to the telephone jack. And in my case, I reconnected everything, and as soon as I put the power and it found the phone there, it connected to the internet immediately. The LED for the internet went back blue, and the telephone LED, which would never light up anymore over the last maybe year or so. We use the Vonage app to a cell phone, so that's what we've done for the last 12 months. But as soon as I reconnected everything and recognized the phone, LED went back blue, and actually I fixed this box. And it should be good for another 8 to 10 years until the caps die on me. So this is the fix. It's very easy fix to do. The level of expertise or difficulty on this repair is fairly low. The most frustrating part would be to desolder the capacitors, but you just need to keep your cool. Do not lose your patience. Don't do like me. All the swears in French came out. All the saints came out. But anyway, it's not that difficult to do. You just need the patience. And I hope that I will be able to help all those that have this Vonage box and that are struggling with Vonage to get the new box. But for me, in the components themselves, the four caps were less than actually $2. So it's a $2 repair, but with tons of patience. And you need to be gentle always with electronics, all right? So hopefully I will help people with that repair. And also please, if I help someone or if you think that this content is interesting, put a like on the video. It makes a big difference. Also, if it helps you, just put a comment down there. It's also good for me to know if I help you guys or if it was helpful. All right. I truly appreciate the comments on the videos. All right. Thanks a lot. And I'll see you at the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.